Nerds, hi yogis, welcome to a Nerdy Yogi YouTube channel and a Nerdy Yogi studio. I'm Carlene Rose, excited to share this practice with you today. As you can see, I added to the decor, very excited about it, got some very cool, very badass Funko Pop characters, two of them being Wonder Woman and the super badass Antiope. So obviously Antiope is the one who trained Wonder Woman in her warrior ways. So doing a workout inspired by her and her awesome move, which her character is doing, and that's the move where she's jumping mid-air, shooting three arrows at once, which was totally badass and awesome. So we are doing a archer pose inspired flow. To start though, we'll come in mountain, just comfortably plant your feet on the ground, start with a little bend in the knees, get a little bit of bounce, use that momentum to wave your spine up nice and tall, fully aligned, one bird ray stacked on top of the other. And we'll start with just some moving breath to warm up. So inhale, reach your arms to the sky. Exhale, hands come through heart center, namaste. We'll do that again. Inhale up. Can you get a little bend in your knees as you inhale to keep that movement? Exhale. Remember, as you're inhaling, to expand everything warm and wide in the low belly and pelvic floor. And exhale, squeezing everything in and out from the pelvic floor all the way up through the nose. Last time here, inhale, exhale. This time we'll inhale up and exhale, extend your arms, press out through your fierce warrior, inhale up. Exhale, extend to the side, use your fierce warrior mudra, inhale up. Exhale, inhale up. Exhale, inhale one last time. Exhale through your fierce warrior mudra. This time we are going to exhale, coming to one side, kind of like you're wrapping around a beach ball, almost to one side and then the other. Opening up the back here, we tend to hold a lot of tension in our shoulders and upper back. Releasing some of that with these poses or with this movement. This time, inhale up again. Exhale through fierce warrior mudra. This time, we'll kind of start our archer pose. So we'll wrap the arm around and draw back. Yeah, like a real archer. Wrap the arm around and back. Inhale, exhale, a couple times on this side. Inhale up, exhale through your fierce warrior mudra, really pressing out through the palms, and inhale, wrap around to the right, exhale, archer with your, pulling back on the bowstring here, inhale, exhale, one last time this side, and inhale up. Exhale, hands back to heart center in namaste. And just shake that out, kind of move all the energy through your body, through your spine. And then from here, make your way to hands and knees. We'll start with little cat cow on hands and knees before we're going into our down dog. So inhale here, exhale, inhale up, exhale. Now this time, make sure that you've tucked your toes, because as we inhale or as we exhale, we're going to lift off the ground just a little, coming off our knees. Inhale, knees back down. Exhale. Inhale up. Exhale. Inhale, last time. Exhale, holding it and making your way back to downward facing dog. Very nice. I'll just pedal up the feet here for a moment. And here we are going to bend everything close to the earth from our down dog. Wave ourselves forward, rolling in and up through the spine, planting our knees, lowering through our chaturanga here. Inhale, prepare. Exhale, waving in and up. And making your way back through on knees or through pointed plank back to down dog. Awesome. From here, we're going to inhale, bend everything and lift the right leg to the sky. To start, we will open our hips to the side and drop the right foot behind us. Excellent. Now keep the knee bent. We are going to bring it up halfway on our mat so you can see I'm at a 90 degree angle with this leg. And then you're going to come onto the pinky toe edge of our foot on the back leg and reach the right arm to the sky. We'll do some circles here, so bending everything towards the earth, circling the arm back and rolling it in and up, extending back up to the sky. One last circle here, getting rid of shoulder tension. And then from here, you can keep your arm up or rotate your palm behind you, come into a half bind behind the back, really grounding into the earth with your right foot, starting to stretch the hips in this position. And make your way back to downward dog, right leg lifts. Exhale, bring knee to chest, core plank one. Inhale up. Exhale, knee to chest for core plank two. Inhale last time. Exhale, really bending everything as you bring your right knee to your chest and step your right foot forward. Awesome. From here, inhale, prepare. Bending the back knee, rolling in and up, making your way to high lunge. From here, we'll do our fierce mudra. Excuse me. So inhale here. Exhale, pressing out through your fierce mudra. Inhale up. Exhale. Last time here, inhaling up. Exhale, pressing out through your palms in fierce mudra. And inhale one last time. This time we're going to rotate onto the back of our back foot into warrior two. And inhale, extend everything. Exhale through fierce warrior mudra. Inhale up. Exhale, get a little bit of flying warrior. Inhale last time. Exhale. Now we're going to do our arrow move again. So circle the arm forward. Pull the arm back, circle the arm forward, pull it back. Now, as you're doing this, I really want you to pull, feeling the strength in your arm. You're not just moving it. Really imagine that you are drawing back on a bow. And last time, awesome. Inhale, reach up, extend everything, and exhale, cartwheel hands back to the earth, making your way back to downward facing dog. Pedaling out the feet for a moment, bending everything close to the earth, rolling yourself in and up, planting the knees, lowering through chaturanga. Inhale here, prepare, roll yourself in and up to cobra, and back to downward facing dog. Remembering to engage your breath this whole practice. You can always take a moment to pause in down dog and catch your breath if you've maybe misplaced it a little. Yeah. Vinyasas are tough flow. But we've got two sides, so we're going to inhale here. Left leg comes to the sky. Start by opening your hips and letting the left foot fall behind you. Should be a nice stretch in the back of the right leg as well as the psoas on the left side. And again, keeping your knee bent, bringing it in and up, and stepping the left foot halfway up the mat, coming to your pinky toe edge. On the back right leg, left leg reaches up to the sky. Do some circling here. So bending everything towards the earth, circle the arm back, bring it back up to the sky. Exhale. And last time here. And if you took the half bind, rotate the palm behind you and wrap it behind your back. Maybe eventually you'll swing your fingertips down there. Hello. I think my shirt's in the way of mine, but holding this for a moment, again, grounding into the earth with your left foot, feeling the stretch, hopefully in your outer hips a little. And grounding your hands back to the earth, making your way back to down dog, left leg lifts high, bending everything, and left knee comes to the chest for core plank one. Inhale back up, exhale for core plank two. Inhale, last one. Come in through core plank three and step your left foot to meet your left thumb. Inhale, prepare, long spine. Bend the back knee, rolling yourself in and up to your high lunge. And from here, our fierce warrior mudra again. So inhale, exhale, pressing out through the palm, bending your back knee, inhale up. As you straighten the knee, exhale. Doing some fierce mudra lunges here. Exhale last time. Inhale this time, grounding the back foot comfortably into the earth, making your way into warrior two. Loosen flying warrior on this side with fierce mudra. So inhale up, exhale, inhale up, exhale. Last time here, exhale. This time we're holding our warrior two, making sure, of course, that our hips and shoulders are in line. Nice stacked spine, and bring your right hand to meet your left and pull back as if you're pulling an arrow. Right fingertips meet up front, pull back. Again, really feeling the strength of that pull, kind of resisting with your right arm. And last one here. Awesome. Inhale up one last time and exhale. Cartwheel your hands back to the earth. Make your way back to downward facing dog. Bending everything towards the earth. Waving yourself in and up. Planting the knees. Lowering through chaturanga. Inhale. Prepare. Wave yourself in and up. And exhale. Back to down dog. And from here, we're going to make our way kind of towards the center of the mat. Feet come up towards your hands. Hands come back toward the feet. Coming into a forward fold for a moment. Hanging, just rocking back and forth. You can bend your knees. Bend one knee and then the other. Find any places of stretch that you want to get to. Wherever you are, though, make sure you're not sticking your spine up like this. You want to have a long folded spine. If that means you're bending your knees a lot to get your spine in alignment, do that. You don't want to strain your leg stretch and hurt your spine. You want to start with having a good spine and then find where your legs stretch and work where you are on the spectrum. Awesome. We're going to test our balance here with a little half moon archer variation. So inhale here, bending everything towards the earth. Really plant your right fingertips out and wide from your shoulder and start lifting the left leg and left elbow up towards the sky. Again, keeping everything really bent, extending long, waving long through the spine first, then extending everything, seeing where you might have balance. And then from here, here's where we're gonna really test our balance. See if you can press into the earth. You can, of course, stay here or grab a block if you need it. But really grounded to the earth, I like to start by bending my right leg and see if you can lift up and bring your right hand up to your chest. Again, in that arrow, you know, drawing an arrow position with the arms. See if you can hold it for just a moment and release everything to the earth. Fantastic job. That is a challenge. And back to our forward fold. You can find your little dance and wave here. Awesome, and then try it on the other side. So start again by bending everything towards the earth, really planting into the earth with your left foot. Fingertips plant strongly out and wide from the left shoulder. Start with bent everything. You can even stay really bent low like this to hold the pose, the balance. You know, wherever you need to be, you work your way up. I've been doing yoga for almost a decade now, so you know, you find where you're at within the pose. The pose is definitely not the finished product, it is the work to get there. So, start with bent everything, then alignment of the spine, then extending the arms and legs to where they need to be. Again, you can hold it here, you can grab a block if you need more support. And you work your way up to the spectrum to start with bending the left leg to really find your balance and bringing your left arm up into a modified variation of that drawing the bow with your arms. See if you can hold the balance for just a moment. If you fall out of it, big who cares, and make your way down as gracefully as you can. Walk out your hips again. And give yourself a big pat on the back for even trying that, because it is not easy. But now you are a badass warrior like the Amazons. So, great job. And from here, we are going to make our way down to sit. You can find your way. Find something comfortable to make your way down. And we're going to come into a Janu Sirsasana. We got one last kind of challenge pose for us. So start right leg is extended long. Left leg comes in to meet the inside of the right leg. We'll just start with a simple doing the stretch. So right arm is going to plant inside the right knee. Start with a bent right leg and just open up to the side. Get a nice stretch. You can extend the left arm overhead if you would like. Opening up the side body. And then from here, as you get more flexible, extending the right leg long. Just finding a comfortable position to rest in. And then from here, turning to face your leg again. Start with bent knee, long spine, then fold, then straighten the leg as you can while keeping the spine in a healthy alignment. You can even wave back and forth here. Now we're going to start by coming to actual archer's pose. So there's a couple of variations. Again, we'll just start in this position here, grabbing your foot, lifting your foot up, keeping your left leg at about a 90 degree angle, just pulling it into your armpit here. You can hold it with both hands and just comfortably hold it here. This is a good archer's pose prep. You can hang out here for the whole pose. Again, keeping long aligned spine, really pressing out through the earth through the right foot. And we're just gonna release that gently. This time putting the left ankle above the knee. You don't want to place it on the knee, but above the knee. We'll stretch out the hips a little here. So wave yourself back and forth. Then start to fold. Remembering all of your good alignment from your forward fold when your knee was on the ground. And walking yourself back up. Now you can stay in this archer pose prep, or if you would like, grab onto your toes. You can yogi lock the big toe, however you can get a good grip, and draw your knee back. Now you can see your elbow, like you're drawing back a bow. Then from here, again, you can start with a bent knee to grab your toe and hang out here, get the flexibility. I want you to work on having a long spine. You see some people do this pose like this, and not super, super great. So keep your shoulders down away from your ears. As you get used to doing this pose, then you can stretch out the leg and yogi toe lock the right toes. But again, this part comes last. You can grab here, wherever you are. And so you can hold it for one more breath and release everything down to the earth. We'll extend both feet, shake them out, windshield wiper the legs. So you can feel the difference between both sides. And then take a moment of gratitude for the fact that we have two sides and we get to do the other. So Janu Sirsasana on this side, left leg is extending, right foot comes in to meet the left leg. Bent here, again, start with bent knee, hook left elbow inside the left knee, twisting to the side, getting into the side body. Again, you can reach the right arm overhead, deepen the side body stretch. And then from here, walk the leg out wherever the stretch may be. Awesome. And from here, folding forward, again, starting with that bent knee, wave the spine long, wave it back and forth. easing your body into the stretch, giving it kind of that fluid, liquid movement, letting it know what you're doing. Coming forward, again, finding your place on the spectrum, wherever you're going to play. And walk yourself back up. We'll start with our archer's pose prep. So, knee comes up, grabbing onto your right foot, lifting up 90 degrees. Again, you can have bent knee here, wherever you need to be, to keep the spine nice and long. You can even, if you need, you can go against a wall, help give you support here. You can put a block behind you, help remind you to keep your spine nice and long when you're doing this pose. You can bend it a little bit more when we're doing the full pose, but you don't want to be, we want to be supporting our spine, not just letting it, you know, fall out of our back. Blech. And right ankle comes above the left knee onto the leg. Again, you can start with a bent leg here, whatever is where you need to be for how you stretch. And wave down. Stretching the left leg and hamstring, even the calf muscle a little bit, as well as getting into your right hip. One more breath here and walk yourself up. And you may notice that your flexibility and strength is different on each side, and that's totally fine. You just keep chipping away with where you're at, and you know, as you practice yoga more, practice the sequences and poses more, you'll even it out a little bit. So again, you can come to the archer pose prep, or if you want, yogi toe lock, big toe, and extend your arm back like your foot is basically the arrow in this pose, drawing your foot back, maintaining healthy spinal alignment, not winging your leg out like this. You can see, you know, you want to keep your knee close to your body, shoulders down, elbows out, and then wherever you need to be for the leg. If it's bent, if you're grabbing here, if you're grabbing here, wherever your stretch is. So you can hold archer's pose for one more big breath. And release it gently all the way to the earth. You can shake it out, windshield wiper the legs. Do a forward fold with both legs, then come into Shavasana. So start with, of course, bent knees, long spine. Wave yourself forward. And slowly start stretching out the legs. And as you're practicing yoga, and kind of anything new that you're learning, if you've just started this practice, or even if you've been doing yoga a long time and just, you know, trying to get to master some poses you haven't done yet, just remember that, you know, Amazons weren't born in a day. They train long, they train hard, and they became some of those badass warriors ever, which is awesome. So just, you know, keep that in mind when you're doing things. It's not going to happen just right away. You got to put the training into it. And before you know it, you'll be midair, you know, shooting 3 arrows, or whatever the equivalent is. So after this forward fold, my nerdy yogis, make your way down to the mat. Find your comfortable Shavasana. Just big exhale. The hard work is done. Take a few minutes to really let this practice settle into the body, this new aligned position that you're in on the floor in this Shavasana. And of course, take any stretches that you feel you might need before really resting here. But I do hope to see you on the mat again next week. Be sure to subscribe to the channel so that you get notifications when the videos come out, as well as get on the League of Nerdy Yogis email list for some exclusive content for the league. Thanks so much, yogis. Namaste.